So I was clicking and got clicking, click happy, and this happens a lot. It probably happened to you guys too, and you're like, what did I do? I thought I just set my pattern to be clear, but if that's the case, I would be able to change it back in this toggle menu, and I don't see an option to do that. I thought maybe I hit transparent, but I don't think that's actually the issue. Let me click this guy. I'm gonna go back and make sure that's not it. No, it's not working. So what I can do is I can go to my history to figure out what did I do? And here we go. Here's like all the stuff. I'm gonna go down to the bottom. I did select, counterclockwise, archive. Why did I archive? So I somehow archived it. Can I unarchive it? Gosh, you know what? I really don't know. Clo does so many things. I don't, yeah, you can. Here it is, unarchive. Why do you even want to archive it? I don't know yet. I haven't run into that, but apparently I somehow archived these pattern pieces. So, oops. But I am glad that happened to me because I do want to show you again, this history is super helpful. And in fact, if you're at a place that you're happy and you really like it, you may even want to save your 3D state. So like right now, I'm like, okay, everything looks okay. Maybe I should save that just so in case I need to go back to it for whatever reason. When I save my file, all my history will be gone. I won't have it anymore. But it's still kind of nice when you're just working in it. Okay, so I'm gonna get rid of that so I have a bigger window. Okay, looks like my pieces are all right side up. That's great. Cool. Okay, so now what if I'd like to do? I'm gonna go over to our 3D window and I can right click here. Oopsies, here we are. Let's see here. Maybe I'll right click on top one of the pattern pieces. So did you notice again that whole right clicking thing? I got a different menu when I right clicked on top of a pattern piece than I did when I just right clicked in midair. So this is a good lesson to try to learn as soon as possible. I'm right clicking on the pattern piece and I can reset all my 2D arrangement. Okay, so it just did it for that one piece. I'm gonna hit edit undo. What? Okay, so it just kind of, I'll show you what it does. I'm gonna try to select all of them. Okay, I'll click drag. There we go. Okay, all of them are selected. I can right click, reset 2D. And what's going on, I'm gonna scroll out, it's just mimicking how I set them over here in the 2D. So usually in Clo, best practice is to actually put your pattern pieces like on this little shaded thing. Just to kind of stay organized. I understand we can't really do the back, but you can just kind of move your piece to the back. And by having them organized over here on the 2D, it'll kind of help you know which piece is for what. So there we are. Oh dear. This little guy, I gotta zoom in. He's too little. I start grabbing stuff I don't need to be grabbing. Okay, there we are. So if that's helpful, you can do that. I can reset the 2D if you need to, but maybe you don't even need to. Now our next challenge is using the arrangement points and putting them on the avatar. Now I do have students tell me, hey Kylie, you actually don't have to use the arrangement points and it'll still work. That's fine. But the arrangement points are really cool and they actually unlock other tools like grading and just other cool stuff. Like, so it's if you can use the arrangement points, you should because it will, like I said, unlock other cool future tools that you're probably not thinking about right now. So always, always, always try to use the arrangement points whenever possible. I know in one of your technique samples, you had a really long, huge skirt that needed to be gathered and you couldn't use the arrangement point for that. And that's okay. But if you can, you should. So, how do you turn on the arrangement points? Do you guys remember? There is a keyboard shortcut, Shift F. If you don't know that, you can always go to your toggle menu and get those points there. Now, again, all you have to do is click a pattern piece one time and then click one of the blue dots. You are trying to click a blue dot, okay? Not trying to click her skin, the blue dot, and it's centered. So I'm gonna pick this center one. Do I wanna go up higher? Yeah, I think I wanna go higher. So I'm gonna click one time. That actually looks pretty good. I can rotate. I'm holding my right mouse, and I do have the option to like move it if I thought it was in a weird position. I can move it, you know, forward, backwards, up, down, all that good stuff. I could even rotate it with the gizmo. So again, I realize you guys have had some gizmo practice. This is an opportunity to get even more. In this case, it worked out really well with my placement points. I'm going to go ahead and click the back. It's selected. I used my left mouse. And you know, instead of right-clicking, why don't I use my keyboard shortcuts? I think that would be more efficient. I know if I hit number 2, that's the front. And let's see, I believe number 8 is the back. And if you don't have that memorized, just keep hitting the numbers till it looks good. Okay, which blue point? Ooh, hey, look at this. Okay, so this is only half our pattern piece. Okay, so maybe what I should do before I place it is I should copy and paste so that we actually have 2 of these. Okay, so to do that, we want to make sure we're in the 2D window. I want to get my letter A pattern tool. We'll be using this guy a lot. I'm going to scooch him over here to the right a little bit. And I'm going to go ahead and right-click it, and I'm going to make clone it. Okay, I want to copy it. I'm going to do symmetric pattern, and I want it to have the sewing copy. I know there's no sewing right now, but when I do sewing, I want it to be the same thing. So symmetric pattern with sewing. I'm just going to click one time with my left mouse, and now the computer is generating this pattern piece for me. I will also have to do that with the sleeve as well. There we are. Okay, dokie. So now I guess I can select probably both pattern pieces, and then I can go back to this arrangement point business. I'm going to click right here. It's okay. I kind of want to move it, but I know Clo's really smart that it might just work okay. Like maybe I should have just done one at a time. I mean, I could use this red gizmo and scooch it. But honestly, I'm not even going to worry about it right now. If there's trouble, then I will go and replace it. But I think that Clo's pretty smart enough to figure it out. Okay, let's see here. What else should we do? I think we'll do the sleeve next. Like I said, we're going to need 2, so I'm going to right-click it. And we are going to say symmetric pattern with sewing. I'm going to go ahead and put it over here on the other side. Now, how do I know which half of the sleeve is the front and which half of the sleeve is the back? So for those of you guys that do have experience with sewing or pattern drafting, you might be familiar with notches. And if we look at this armhole, there's one notch. This one notch, single notch, is on the front pattern piece. What about the back pattern piece? That's the other place where the sleeve will get sewn. So normally there's 2 notches on the back, a double notch, but hey, this was a free pattern from the internet, so that didn't happen. But there are notches, and those notches are supposed to help us line up the sleeve to make sure we're lining it the right way. I'm going to switch my tool to the edit pattern tool, letter Z, because I want to select just part of the pattern. I'm going to click this segment. That didn't work. Let me try again. There we are. Okay, so I think because we imported this pattern, it's not really recognizing this notch as a true notch, and I really don't care about these annotations. I honestly would rather just delete them. They're kind of annoying. I want to get it out of my way. Go away. Trying to delete. Hit delete. Okay, you delete too. Okay, it's going to take me a minute to delete them all. But really what I want to do is I want to put a real notch there. So I'm going to show you the notch tool in Clo, and here it is, right here. So I'm going to click that guy one time, and I'm just going to click right here. Okay. I think it put a notch in. Let's find out. I'm going to switch to the letter Z so that I can select just this one segment. I don't think the notch tool went in. Let me try one more time. Notch. Click right there. No, yeah, it's there. Okay. Let's try this again. Oh my gosh. I'm going to delete this. Oh, the notch went on the red tool. Okay, let's try this again. Click. There we go. I finally see the notch. That's exciting. I'm going to switch to the letter Z tool. And the segments keeps going. Interesting. So I think what I want to do is I'm just going to split it right here. Or I'm going to say cancel. I'm going to click right here and add point. Let's see if that works. Okay. I need to delete this stuff. It's just too much. So this point, I'm going to right click and I'm going to convert this to a curve point. Actually, don't want to delete it. I do want to add a point right where the notch is. So I'm going to hit the letter X, which I know this is a new tool. I'm moving so fast. But if you hit the letter X, there's a tool under your edit pattern tool that can add a point. And that's what I want to do. I just want to add a point where I put the notch. I'm going to click one time right here. Hopefully, okay, great. Now I have a point. Why I did that is so now if I hit my edit pattern tool, I can select it and I can see how long my line is. My line is 4.341 inches. So from the shoulder to my notch, it's 4.341. So I just want to figure out which side of my sleeve is also that measurement so I know who's the front and who's the back, basically. Or actually, maybe I'll measure it from the underarm. So I'm going to click the line. Underarm to the point is actually 4.127. So is this line also 4.127 where that notch is? Let's find out. Let's see if it's easier to click this notch. Here we go. Okay. I don't like this point. So I know I'm in the Z tool. I'm going to click this little. It looks like a notch, but it's not really. It's just annotated on our pattern. Okay. So now I'm going to hit X. And I'm gonna click right there. Now I'm gonna hit Z, and then I'll be able to select this segment. And let's see how big it is. Okay, so this is 3.824 inches. Let's go look. And the other one, this guy was 4. So that's a pretty big difference. Let's go see about the notch on the front. That was our back. So this might be the front and this might be the back. And you know, here's the notch on the back. Why don't I just go ahead and see what this is? I'm gonna hit Z so I can click and drag and move that little guy. I'm gonna hit X so that I can split the line. And then I'm gonna hit Z so I can select the segment. Ooh, 5. Okay, so it looks like there might be some easing in this pattern. Easing is when sewers sew a longer piece to a shorter piece. Perhaps that's what it is. Or maybe it's not the best pattern in the world because it was free. It could be a bad pattern. That's another thing as well. So yeah, things to think about here. I'm thinking though that this is the backside that's 5.5. And then this part here that's only 3.8, I'm thinking that goes to the front. So just for my own sanity, I'm actually going to delete this annotation. I don't like it. And okay. And then what I want to do is I actually want to add a double notch so that I know I've decided you are the back. So I'm going to put click. And let's do another one. Click. Okay. So now I can see I decided back versus front. Do you think it did this on my mirrored sleeve? Let's see. I know if I change it, it'll copy, but I don't know about adding notches. It added the point I did, but it didn't add the notches. So that's interesting. Okay. Great. Here we go. So this sleeve right here, if this is going to be the front and that's the back, that means it's going to go on the avatar's left arm. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead to the 3D window. I'm going to click the number 2. I'm going to click this guy, and I know I want it on her left arm. To put the sleeve on, maybe I'll kind of rotate over here. I'm going to get that blue dot. Click. Cool. And you can see it also did the other one, which was handy. Okay, great. You know, again, you guys, it's only module 3. Maybe these extra pieces are too much. So I think for this video demonstration, I'm not going to do them. I'm just going to get rid of these necklines and just kind of make this a bit more of a simple pattern. Because we're doing a lot, I realize. Let me just delete it. And I'm going to go ahead and delete the back band as well around the neck. I just think it's too much for week 3. Okay, so there we go. We arranged our pieces. So the next challenge is going to be to sew them, and you're going to want to use your sewing tool. So I think I'll stop this video and just do a new one just to kind of break it up.